Sarvebhyah Ram Ram Ram. In today's lesson, we will be studying about the very important topic called origin of sound. At the end of this lesson, we will be able to understand how a sound is produced. What are the places of pronunciation of these sounds? What are the sutras to remember the same? The effort involved in pronunciation. Now, these pronunciation aspects are told in the Shiksha Shastra. It is called the science of phonetics. It is a part of the Vedas. And since the oral tradition was predominant in those days, especially for transfer of knowledge, Vedic knowledge, the study of phonetics was very, very important for the sages and the students, the teachers and students of those days. What we will understand by the end of this class, by this lesson, is the science of phonetics is very advanced in our ancient knowledge system. Today, what we have achieved in modern science with the help of advanced cameras which can be placed inside the body and which can analyze how exactly the sound is produced, how the vocal cords vibrate, how the air flows contributing for the sound. All this science of phonetics was very advanced and it has been captured in the Shiksha Shastras. Paniniya Shiksha is one such Shiksha Grantha which captures all this very beautifully. How does the sound or the varnas, how are they produced? Katham varnanam utpattihi katham bhavati. First, there is a shabda prayoga icha. There is a desire to produce the sound. So, how the atma, the self, through the intelligence of the buddhi, will communicate with the manas to ignite the kayagni. Kayagni, what does kayagni do? The kayagnina preritaha vayuhu nabhi pradeshat agatya sarvan kantadi sthanan sthaneshu sancharati. The kayagni, the air from the lungs, is moved towards the vocal cords or the vocal folds by the coordinated action of the diaphragm, abdominal muscles, chest muscles, rib cage, etc. And it passes over the vocal cords, which then converts it into voiced sound, and then it gets converted into recognizable sounds after it passes over the places or the points of articulation. Let me repeat here. When there is a shabda prayoga icha, there is a desire to produce sound and we have to communicate and we have the desire to say a sentence so that the other person can understand, the atma, the self, through the buddhi shall ignite the manas. Through the buddhi shall communicate with the manas to ignite the kayagni, and the kayagni will influence the lungs to push air towards the vocal cords, and by the coordinated action of the diaphragm, the abdominal muscles, the chest muscles and the rib cage, the air passes through the vocal cords and converts into voice sound, and it gets articulated into recognizable sounds after it passes over the points of articulation. Our science of Shiksha called these points of articulation as sthanani. Now, when the air passes through these points of articulation, or this voiced sound passes through these points of articulation, a recognizable sound is produced. Say, A, Ramaha, Sita, Krishnaha. These are recognizable sounds. If I just do some sound, if I produce, they are some other sounds. They are not recognizable sounds by the other person. The sthanani actually are 8 places. I have written here 6 places. There should be a correction in the presentation. After the points of articulation, we have something called the effort of pronunciation, the prayatna. So what happens is there are two kinds of efforts that is there. The effort made before the pronunciation, which is called Abhyantara Prayatna in Shiksha Shastra. Abhyantara Prayatna. There are five types of Abhyantara Prayatna that takes place, depending on what we have to pronounce. Sprishta, Ishat Sprishta, Ishat Vivrita, Vivrita Samvrita. These are the five types of internal effort which takes place inside the body before the pronunciation is made. Sprishta is contacted, full contact is there over the place. Ishat Sprishta, Ishat Vivrita, Ishat Sprishta is slightly contacted, slightly open, open and tight. Now, this has to be studied in detail as a science. It cannot be explained over one class. I have tried to summarize it so that you can get an idea. Now, this Abhyantara Prayatna is internal effort. The next effort that we see is the external effort. There are 11 types of external efforts which the Shiksha Shastra tries to address. We will not get into all the details of external efforts because that is a detailed, Shiksha Shastra itself is a detailed science. So the external effort refers to what is external here, the outside the curved portion of the lips to the kantha. Now here there is a kantha, there is a lip here. This curved portion, in this curved portion, whatever happens is internal. Outside this curved portion is the external effort. Now the external effort is different for swaras and vyanjanas. Now, one external effort that we all understand is the Alpa Prana and Mahaprana. Now, this is done during the pronunciation, external effort. Now, what happens here is Badhnati, Badhnati. Let us take the example of the word Badhnati. Badhnati has got a Dhakara, which is Mahaprana. Now, if I suppose say Badhnati, the teacher will call me and say, you have not pronounced it properly, why don't you stress on the breath on the dhakara to make it a mahaprana. So during the pronunciation, I make the external effort, badhnati, and I make sure I pronounce it. These are examples of external efforts. So alpa prana and mahaprana is one such external effort that we can easily discern, and that is for vyanjanas. Similarly, for swaras, you have nasal effort, non-nasal efforts. We have Vedic swaras. For swaras, we have the Udatta, Anudatta, Swarita, and other swaras for the Vedas. All this has to be studied in Shiksha Shastra. Now, which are these eight sthanani that we are talking about? The first sthana is the nasal effort, Nasika. You can see the picture there. Murdha is the hard palate. Hard palate. Oshthav, the lips. Dantaha, the teeth. Talu is the soft palate. Kantha is the throat. Jihvamula, the edge of the tongue on the other side. Then what is not there in the diagram there is Uraha. In Pratishakya, the Vedic grammar, they talk about Uraha. Now, these eight sthanas are the sthanas recognized by our science of phonetics.